Hi, I'm Shelley, one of the nurse educators for the Pediatric Diabetes Resource Center. Technology in the world of diabetes is forever changing, which requires more education. Therefore, I put together some basic information on automated insulin pump systems. First of all, what is an automated insulin pump? It's an insulin pump that is integrated with a continuous glucose monitoring system, which uses its predictive algorithm to reduce low and high blood sugars. In other words, these pumps have the ability to adjust doses continuously on their own to keep the user in their blood sugar range. We at the Pediatric Diabetes Resource Center use three pumps with this technology: Medtronic, Tandem, and Omnipod. Basic functions of an automated system require a continuous glucose monitoring system which is integrated. The Tandem pump uses the Dexcom G6 and G7. The Omnipod pump uses the Dexcom G6. Both pump companies are working towards possibly using also the Freestyle Libre. Medtronic uses its own sensor called the Guardian. For your students to start these systems, they meet with a pump educator from our center to enter individual doses into the pump, such as the basal rates, insulin to carb ratios, correction factors, and targets. The pumps use their own designed algorithms to keep the blood sugars in target range. They do this by increasing the dosage to lower the blood sugars as well as decreasing the dosage to increase the blood sugar. Keep in mind, the user must still enter blood sugar and carbohydrates into the pump. As discussed earlier, low blood sugars are the most common concern with students at school. The automated systems are designed to prevent these occurrences. Once the algorithm predicts that the blood sugar will be lower than target, the insulin dose is stopped. Since the pump is treating the low blood sugar on its own, the student doesn't need to follow the typical rule of 15. Instead of using 15 grams of a rapid-acting carbohydrate, we at the Pediatric Diabetes Resource Center recommend using 7 to 8 grams only. Helpful hints to consider with the automated insulin pump system at school are bolus history. This will inform you of insulin dosage recently delivered. Insulin on board will be on the main screen, which this explains how many units have been delivered and still working to decrease the blood sugar. Phones are used as a medical device. The Omnipod 5 requires a phone to receive the Dexcom alarms. The pump will trigger the dose to be delivered, and like all insulin pumps, whether they are integrated with continuous glucose sensors or not, again, carbohydrates need to be entered into the pump. At times, you may find your student without the continuous glucose system. For example, we get calls from concerned school staff that the student isn't wearing his or her Dexcom. The pump will still operate as a basic pump, but will not be able to use its automated features. Therefore, I remind you that the pump will not be able to treat low blood sugars. There are various reasons as to why the student is not wearing the Dexcom. One important reason to understand is that insurance only pays for 3 sensors a month. If, for example, a sensor is accidentally ripped off of the skin, they could go short of their monthly supply and therefore have to rely on finger sticks. These products have a very expensive out-of-pocket cost. Future technology. Pumps and continuous glucose monitoring companies are constantly working to improve their products. As new pumps are on the market, new education and understanding of the systems are required. I hope you appreciated my slides I put together and the information, therefore you can understand the automated insulin pump systems a little bit more. Thank you.